Hello everyone, and welcome to my video today that is about Greek etymology. More precisely, we are going to look into word prefixes and their meanings. For practical reasons, this video will be presented in two parts. In the end of this presentation, you will be able to understand better word construction and guess the meaning of new words that contain the given prefixes. It's good to bear in mind that in Greek, each individual word carries a meaning. Therefore, by learning to look into words, we understand the Greek language more profoundly. So, it's time for work now. We'll be starting with the prefix syn, that means together. You probably know the word symphony, that stands for it's a deal, done. We say this when we agree with someone. But what does it mean exactly? It means that we together share the same voice. We agree. Likewise, συγγενής is made up of syn and genus, and means relative, someone that comes from the same white family. Συνάδελφος is made up of syn and αδελφός, that is brother or mate, and it means altogether colleague. Συνεργάζομαι comes from syn and εργάζομαι, to work, and means to collaborate. Συγχαρητήρια, syn, and χαίρομαι, to be happy, means congratulations. I share your happiness. Next, we'll be looking into prefix υπό, that stands for under. Those of you with house-seeking experience should be familiar with the word υπόγειο, basement. How comes though and υπόγειο means basement? Well, υπό means under something and γη means earth, ground. So the floor that is under the ground is called υπόγειο in Greek. Likewise, υπογράφω, that is made up of υπό and γράφω, right, means to sign. We usually sign under a text or other thing. Υποκατάστημα, υπό and κατάστημα, shop, means branch, a shop under the main shop. Υποδιευθυντής, υπό and διευθυντής, director, means altogether deputy director, the person under the director. Υπολειτουργώ, υπό and λειτουργώ, to function, means to function under the normal standards, to act up. Whereas υποτιμώ comes from υπό, under, and τιμή, price or value, and means altogether to underestimate. Prefix ανά, that has a double meaning, will be our next stop. Sometimes it has the meaning of on something, and some other times of repetition. Have you heard of the word ανάποδα? What does it mean? It means the feet up, or upside down, the opposite direction. Ανάμνηση, ανά plus μνήμη, remembrance, is the word for recollection. Αναγράφω, ανά plus γράφω, to write, means to reference, to list on. Αναβάλω, ανά plus βάλω, to put, in this example, to put for later on or to postpone. Curious about the verb ανάβω, that means to light up or switch on. Well, the verb ανάβω comes from ανά plus άπτω, that means in ancient Greek, to touch. Prefix ανά though can have another second meaning, that of repetition. Αναγέννηση is the word for renaissance. Ανά, again, and γέννηση, birth. Likewise, αναγεννίζω, that is made up of ανά and καινούριος, new, means to renovate. Anatheoro, ana plus theoro, to consider, means to reconsider. And how about anagnorizo? Gnorizo is to be acquainted with, to know something. Altogether, anagnorizo means to recognize. We move on to prefix kata. The odds are you related already to the adverb kato. That's right, well done. For instance, we have the word katapino, that is made up of kata and pino, to drink. Altogether, it means to swallow. Katatheto means literally to place down. In other words, to deposit or to attest. Katalogos is made up of kata and lego, to say. So, it's a catalog or a directory. And how about kataskinono? Some people often do it in nature. This word comes from kata and skini, a tent, and is the verb for camping, doing camping. Kata prefix, though, can have a second meaning, relatively common as well, that of very much. Katakokinos means bit red, very red. Katatromazo, to scare someone to death. Kataklevo, to rip someone off. Anyone knowing why kategida ended up meaning storm or thunderstorm? Aegis, that is the word for god in ancient Greek, was also Zeus's shield. And we know from mythology that Zeus used to send thunders to punish people. Is the prefix for inside. We meet the sign isodos on doors and gates. Isodos, containing the word odos, way or road, is the word for entrance. Isiterio comes from is and ini, that is the verb in ancient Greek, to come. Therefore, isiterio is the thing, usually a piece of paper, that enables us to come into a place, a ticket. Isago is made up of is and ago, to drive or to lead, and means altogether to import. Ispneo is and pneo, to breathe, means to inhale. Ek or ex, if the next word starts with a vowel, means the exact opposite, outside. Exodos, ek and odos, means the exit. Ekpneo, ek and pneo, means to breathe out, to exhale. Ektheto or ekthesi, the noun, contains the verb theto, to place, thus to exhibit or an exhibition. Any clues why ecclesia, a church, is called like that? The literal meaning of ecclesia is to call, kalo, to call out, to invite people out. Hyper is another prefix with a double meaning. Very often it has the meaning of too much, excess. For example, hyperogos is made up of hyper and ogos, volume, and means extortionate. Hyperoria, hyper plus ora, hour, means overtime. Hyperveno, hyper plus veno, to go, means to exceed. And what is the exact meaning of hyperochos? Well, hyperochos is someone whose virtues are above normal, in other words, fabulous, splendid, exquisite. Let's look now at the second meaning of hyper. Hyper, in ancient Greek, was the preposition for in favor of. So, when we meet it as a prefix in verbs, it is likely to have the meaning of doing something in favor of someone or something. Hyperaspizome, for instance, comes from hyper and aspida, a shield, and means to defend, Hyperpsychesia, hyper and psychesia, to vote, means to vote for something. Xe is a modern Greek preposition with a double meaning as well. Usually it has the meaning of doing the opposite of what the verb says, to undo. Ξεκουράζω means to give rest. Ξεκλειδώνω means to unlock. Ξεκουμπώνω, to unbutton, and ξενικιάζω, to rent out. Some other times, though, it is used for emphasis. It means completely. Ξεπαγώνω, ξε plus παγώνω, to freeze, means to frost. Ξεμπερδεύω, ξε plus μπερδεύω, to confuse, means to disentangle, to get it over with something. Ξετρελαίνω, ξετρελαίνομαι, ξε plus τρελαίνω or τρελαίνομαι, active and middle passive. To make or go crazy means to drive or go mad about something. Ξεκαρδίζομαι, ξε plus καρδιά, heart, means to laugh my heart out, to laugh very hard. Our last prefix for this video is amphi, that means both sides. Amphisimos comes from simeno, to mean, so something that can mean both things is ambiguous. Likewise, amphivalo, amphi plus valo, to hit, means to doubt. Amphitheatro, amphi plus theatro, theater, is an amphitheater, a place with a round shape that enables us to see from all sides. Amphitaladevome comes from amphi and taladevome, to move backwards and forwards like a pendant, and means to waffle or oscillate. I tried to cover the main aspects of these common prefixes. In my next video to come, I'll complete the prefixes section. Remember that by learning to analyze Greek words correctly, you don't only get the meaning right, but also learn to spell words correctly, memorize the new words easier, and get more flexible and creative with the use of Greek language. Σας ευχαριστώ πολύ. Περιμένω τα σχόλιά σας. Adios.